So hopefully what you said was that number letter A is definitely organic. So I'm just going to put an O with a checkbox, and it is, because it's made out of carbon and hydrogen. Perfect. Is it also a hydrocarbon? So I'm going to put H. Is it also a hydrocarbon? Yes, it is, because it only has carbon and hydrogen. In fact, this is the most simple, the smallest form of carbon called methane, okay? So you might know, like, methane, like, smells bad. It's released, like, in gas, so sorry. It's too much information, but whatever. That is an organic molecule. How about this next one here? Hopefully you said that, yes, this is organic, okay? Because once again, it has carbon and it has hydrogen. Is it a hydrocarbon? No, this would not be a hydrocarbon. The reason is because it has an oxygen there. See how I have an atom that is not a carbon or a hydrogen? So that means that this is considered just an organic molecule. In fact, this is acetone. So if you guys, maybe you girls use acetone to like take your nail polish off, whatever. I hate that smell. It's like disgusting. That's what the molecule looks like, all right? We're going to be learning about a lot of really cool molecules. At least I think they're cool, right? I have to think they're cool. I'm a tutor. But they are really cool. So hopefully you'll get to know them too. Don't memorize these names yet. I'm just giving you some information for later, okay? Then finally, this last one, hopefully you guys said, is that this was not organic and also it was not a hydrocarbon, okay? The reason is because I do have a carbon here, but I do not have a hydrogen. Okay, there are no hydrogens, so this is not an organic molecule. In fact, this is what we consider, and this can be a little bit confusing, inorganic carbon, like not organic. This would be a form of inorganic carbon because it doesn't have any hydrogens at all. In fact, this is CO2 or carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide, you know, that's like a greenhouse gas, it goes into the air, that's considered inorganic. We would learn about this a little bit more in Gen Chem because that has to do more with inorganic. And then for organic, we would deal more with the molecules that have hydrogens on them, okay? That's a general rule.